My name is Konstantin Dmitriev, and I'm here to talk about Remake. Remake is a new utility that helps you to automate rendering of many files when you're working on the animation project. Let's begin with the question, why you might need Remake in such work, in such kind of work. Typical animation project is divided into shots or scenes or whatever you call it. Look at the picture, illustration. We have shot one, shot two, etc. And all shots are composed together into video sequence file. And to be inserted into video sequence file, each shot should be rendered. Also, each shot usually several assets. It could be characters, backgrounds, color charts, etc. Those assets could reside in the shot file itself, or they can reside in external file. For example, here color chart file is separate file, or even more, we can have two-dimensional shot made in CFX Studio, for example, including 3D background file made in Blender, for example, here. We have. And the 3D file can have its own set of objects, textures, etc. Maybe some assets are shared between different shots, as we can see. This texture file is used here and in this shot. As you can see, the whole picture could be quite complex. Consider that typical for example, 4 minutes. If your project is 4 minutes long, your animation is 4 minutes long, it could contain up to 50 shots. And you can see that, for example, if we change a texture file, we need to re-render this 3D background file, right, to have updated. It updated and then re-render this two-dimensional file to view the changes in video in the whole video sequence file. And also we'll need to re-render this three-dimensional file. As you can see, even a tiny change can influence the whole project or a significant part of it. So here's the problem. We have many files with different links, and one change may require rendering of many files, or maybe the whole project. But when we're working with the project, we always need to have our rendering up to date to work with scenes in the sequence, to watch what we have. At the same time, we don't want to render each file manually. For example, we changed this file, this file, this file. So I need to start rendering for this file and wait when it finished. When start next, I wait again. Next, that's crazy. We don't want that. We need automatic rendering. And we don't want to do full re-rendering of the whole project. Imagine I'm changing one file, a teeny file. It doesn't influence the whole project, maybe some two or one scene, one shot. And I don't want to re-render everything. I want to re-render only those files which are influenced by the change. So we want effective rendering. It's very hard to do an animation project by yourself when you're alone. And most probably when you're working on animation project, you're collaborating with someone because it's easier, it's more fun. And when you're collaborating with someone online, then most probably you will want to optimize the transfer of data, the amount of transferred data. One of the most effective solutions in this case is to transfer source of files or source of files only of your animation. And that means that the person you're collaborating with will face the same problem. He or she will need to render files as well. The problem becomes even worse in case of multiple people collaborating on the project. Because imagine someone changes this file, someone changed that file. We can track which files were changed, but this doesn't help, because to render correctly, to update the video sequence file, we need to know the structure of each shot. We need what should be rendered. If I know that this file was changed, then I need to know where it is used and what I need to render to have the whole picture up to date.
Can you still hear? I guess not. Oops. It's commercial time. I guess.
Oh. Thank God. Okay, I didn't broke anything. And when we're talking about rendering problem, it becomes obvious that we need some rendering parameters controlled globally. That leads us to the concept of the project as a unit containing all the source files and render settings defined for the whole project. For example, when you're working on some project, you might want to work with lower resolution to have a faster rendering, have faster updates. And when your project is come to the finish, you want to quickly switch to another resolution and quickly re-render all your stuff. Or, for example, if you work on commercial project and the customer at the last moment asks, hey, you need to deliver a result in another resolution, twice higher than the original. Oh, what time is it? And you need quickly switch resolution again. So that is an important point. What I was talking about. Okay. So you need the settings defined globally. And of course, you may write some scripts that store the rendering parameters globally and do rendering for you. But consider that we're talking about the animation project in development. That means that the structure of our project is constantly changing. It can change drastically. And you end up in constantly changing your scripts. Or you may write a smart script that consider file dependencies and do a smart rendering. And then you will end up with the same thing that I did. You will write remake. But hey, since it's already here, let's take a look at it. Remake is internally uses a GNU-make utility. I guess I don't need to explain what is GNU-make utility. Everyone uses it to build software. And Remake uses it to track changed files. How does it technically works? The first remake analyzes files given to render and all its dependencies and generates a make file with all necessary rules which are understandable by make. And finally, it goes make invocation and make detects the changes and executes those rules. That's it. Remake have a modular architecture, and the list of supported software can be easily extended. Currently supported software is Blender, Synfig Studio, and Pencil. In case of Pencil, you will need a patched version, not official. It's on our website. Remake recognizes two types of dependencies. It's direct dependency, when we have one file directly included into other. For example, the shot.c file uses color chart.c file. And when we ask remake to render shot.c file, it checks if both files were changed since the last rendering, and if some of them were, it renders it. If not, no render. And the second type is indirect dependency. For example, we cannot directly include shot.synfig file into Blender file because Blender can't read synfig files. And to be inserted into Blender, the synfig file should be rendered first as image sequence. And only after that, this image sequence is inserted into Blender file. This is indirect dependency. And as you can see, remake needs to be able to determine the source of file for each rendering. It needs to know what is the source file to set up this link. And this is achieved by introducing one simple rule to file naming. For example, is it okay? Okay. We have a project with configuration file, defining the resolution, frame rate, etc. It's a project. And the rendering of 01 shot.cif will be placed in the render subdirectory under the same path. You see, 01 shot.cif will be rendered into 01 shot.cif, but adding the default the rendered format at the end, at the name. As you can see, it could be easily determined from the path which source of file is. And this is a very good rule because because of two reasons. Because we have all renderings are separated inside of the, inside of the rendering subdirectory of the project. We can delete it anytime if we like. And we know which main things are located. I know where is the rendering of this file, or I know where is the source file of this rendering. So this is very good. It's a kind of standard. It's a very easy to follow this rule. Just use remake to when you want to render something. Just use it, and I will show how it works. For example, here we have a sequence file. It's not much here. You see some elements, shots. It's just the titles. And for example, we want to insert file located in 01 shot.cif. This animation, Oh, it's a little, not much space. How can I fix it? Okay. Okay, I want to insert this animation. And I cannot insert Synfig file into Blender, so I need to render it. Okay. In terminal, we call remake 01 shot.sif. It will not take much time. 1 second. Okay, done. Now we can see that there is a corresponding subdirectory appear in the render and shot.sif.png. And here is the rendering sequence. Now I can insert it into Blender. Okay, render 01 shot.sif. Oh. Okay. It's okay. Oh, it's too short. I will double. Okay. And when I inserted the file in the such way, at the same time I have established the link between the sequence file and this shot file. From the point of view of remake, they are linked now. So let's demonstrate how we work with changing files. For example, I will change something in this file by adding color charts. Chart, for example, file import. Oh, where I am? Yeah. We have color chart. Very nice. I don't have much colors here, but I will color your skin. Where you are? Okay. Oh. Okay. And hairs. Okay, we changed something in this file, and we can change some other files. For example, this. Okay, we have made some changes, and this the sequence file is not reflecting our changes because nothing was rendered yet, right? And I need to update the rendering now. And the funny thing that I don't need to know which files were changed to update the rendering. I want to update rendering for this file, so I just call remake for this file and only dependencies. I don't want to render this file by itself. I want to render only the linked files, the files used in this file. okay. I promise it won't take a much time. Okay, done. And we have everything up to date. Okay, save. Now, let's demonstrate one more thing. Supposing which transferred sources to someone else. To simulate this, I just kill render subdirectory. I just kill all rendered footage. Done. You see, we have nothing empty, nothing is rendered, but it's easy to fix that. I just call rendering and it will restore all your project from sources. Okay. So you can build your project from sources with almost a single click. And it's also possible to produce the resulting file. Just call remake without. I want to render file itself without parameters. Okay. And we have MPG file in render subdirectory. So it's very good because we don't need to store all the rendered footage because it a lot of space and rendering, and we just store source, can transfer to someone else, and anyone can restore the rendering from by using the one single command. So let's summarize the advantages we have with Remake. We have common structure for animation projects. We know where where everything is located. Where is rendering? Where is this? Where is configuration? So it's very good for collaboration. We can render animation from sources with one click. It's very good for open movies because when you do open movie, you probably want someone to modify it, but modify is not enough because even if you modify something, you need to build it, you need to render everything, and this is a very tricky task for some users. This is a barrier. And we also have reduced the time for re-rendering because if I'll try to render without making any changes, you will see that no rendering take place. No changes, no rendering. It's okay. Remake is already used in several animation projects, open source and commercial ones. Here's I listed some of them, what you can find on the web. And you can watch them by yourself. And before I finish, I want to outline the development perspectives for this project. We want to implement a network rendering to be able to use several computers during rendering, some kind of render farming. And this is one of the top priority tasks. We also would like to have a template system because, what do I mean? When you add in an empty Blender file, it's not adapted to your project. It has different settings. And we want templates that you, if you add in Blender file, you it automatically adapted to the resolution, frame rate, etc. And we also would like to have more complex templates, like for 3D stereo rendering, like with camera rig, you know. And also there are many templates for Synfig. It would be very good to include them too. Also, we would like to have a transparent integration with software. At this moment, you can see that you need to manually render it. If you want to insert Synfig file into Blender or Blender file into Synfig, you need to manually call Remake. You need to render it manually. But it would be very nice if you just click Synfig file in Blender and Blender detects, oh, it's a part of Remake. I cannot import Synfig file, but Remake can, and he calls Remake, re-renders it, and inserts the rendered image sequence into Blender. It's all transparent. It would be very good addition to workflow. And the same thing for Synfig. I click Blender file, it renders, takes some time, but it inserts directly, and it works like a bridge between applications. It also works for interoperability. And also, it would be nice to have some graphic user interface because many users are scared of command line. That's all. And I'm ready for your questions. Anyone? Yes, please. I'm sorry. Ah, what's the difference between make and remake?
Yeah, how much make? I think you know, underestimating how much extra work it costs to get the work in, but it's not really been a bit long. How much work is there inside of the remake itself?
Oh, I'm sorry, I can't understand. How much it worked to, how much... How it's different? To build this software?
No.
Oh, from regular Mac. For regular Mac, you need to write rules, right? And here you don't need to write rules. All dependence remake takes all work to analyze analyze dependencies in your project. It and generates necessary make file. That's it. And the rest of the work is done by make. That's it. You don't need to write any rules for your project. I can show you a sample. I can show you. This is a test project one. You can see the Amontos shots. It's pretty much render. I want to show make file. I hope. Oh. Okay. Then I'll do this. Oh, it's. K. I need to. K options. Wait a moment. File. It removes make file at the end, so I need to specify K option. Oh, I better some smaller file. It's too long to wait. I will use simple scene better because here it is. Here's a sample for one shot, and you have that amount of shots. You can see that writing such make file is very difficult, and it's very difficult to maintain it. You can multiply it to the count of shots here. That's the work. So any more questions? Yes, Tim. Well, you can extend the list of supported software by writing modules, but the only requirement for software to be supported is this software should be able to call rendering through command line. That's a requirement. And there is no much problem with that. Anyone else? Yes, please. What is the maximum resolution? It depends on the software. It depends it depends on the software you're using for rendering. Remake is not rendering render system by itself. It just call render operations. If you use Blender, it's limited to maximum resolution of Blender. If Synfig, it's Synfig. Anyone? Well, I guess that's it. Thank you.